10th standard, geography 6th lesson, physical geography of Tamil Nadu. In this lesson, we are going to see about the history of formation of Tamil Nadu, major physiographic divisions of Tamil Nadu, climate, soil and natural vegetation of Tamil Nadu, and the geographical conditions of their living places in Tamil Nadu. That about that we are going to see in this lesson. Tamil Nadu has long and sunny beaches, waterfalls, hills, forest and varied flora and fauna. As per the State Reorganization Act of 1956, state boundaries were reorganized on some linguistic basis. Location and size of Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu is one of the 28 states of India, located in the southernmost part of the country. Its extremities are in the eastern point Kalimer, in the western side hills of Anaimalai, in northern Pulikkad Lake, in southern Cape of Comorin. It covers an area of 130,058 square kilometer and it is the 11th largest state in India. It covers 4% of the area of our country. Now, boundaries and neighbors. Tamil Nadu is bounded by the Bay of Bengal in the east, Kerala in the west, Andhra Pradesh in the north, Karnataka in the northwest, and Indian Ocean in the south, Gulf of Mannar and Park Strait separate Tamil Nadu from the island of Sri Lanka. The state has 940 km long coastline, the second longest in India after Gujarat. So Gujarat ranks first place in all over the India in the beach, longest beach, and Tamil Nadu ranks second place in the longest beach in India. Administrative divisions. At present, there are 37 districts in Tamil Nadu, including the newly created district such as Kallakurichi, Tenkasi, Chengalpet, Ranipet and Tirupattur. We are going to see about physiographic divisions of Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu is located on the peninsular plateau. It is known as Deccan Plateau. Tamil Nadu is divided into four physical divisions like Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats, Plateaus, Coastal and Inland Plains. So there are the four physical divisions, that is Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats, Plateaus and Coastal and Inland Plains. Plateaus and plains. So plains is divided into coastal and inland plains. These are the four divisions. Now we'll see about one by one. Now we'll see Western Ghats. Western Ghats extended from the Nilgiris in the north to Swami Thop in Kanyakumari district in the south. Its height is 2000 to 3000 meters. It covers an area of 2500 square kilometer. It is a continuous range. It has some passes. Like name of the passes are Palkat, Senkotai, Aralvai Muli and Achan Koyil. The Nilgiris, Anaimalai, Palani Hills, Cardamon Hills, Varsanadu Hills, Andipatti Hills, Agastyar Hills are the major hills of the Western Ghats. In the Western Ghats, there are the different hills are there. We'll see one by one hills like Nilgiri Hills, Anaimalai Hills, Palani Hills, Cardamon Hills, etc. We'll see one by one about the hills. The Nilgiri Hills is located in the northwestern part of Tamil Nadu. It consists of 24 peaks with more than 2000 meter height. Thottapetta is the highest peak of these hills. Ooty and Kunnur are the major hill stations located in these hills. The state animal Nilgiri Tahar is found in this hill. Anaimalai Hills. Anaimalai is located in the border of Tamil Nadu and Kerala. It is located to the south of Palakkad Gap. Anaimalai Tiger Reserves, Aliyar Reserved Forest, Valparai Hill Station, Kadamparai Hydroelectricity Power Plant are located on this hill. Aliyar and Tirumurthi Dams are located at the foothills of the Anaimalai. Now Palani Hills. These hills are located in Dindukal district. Vandaravu is the highest peak in the Palani Hills. Vandaravu is the highest peak in the Palani Hills. Cardamon Hills. These hills are also known as Ela Malai Hills, located in the southwestern part of Tamil Nadu. It acquires its names from the cardamom spice, which is commonly grown here. So in the Ela Malai, the cardamoms are more famous. That is what it is called as Cardamom Hills or Ela Malai. Pepper and coffee are the other crops cultivated over the hills. Next to the Cardamom Hills, Varusanadu and Andipatti Hills. Varusanadu Hills, eastward extension of Western Ghats is Varusanadu and Andipatti Hills. In the eastward extension of Western Ghats is Varusanadu and Andipatti Hills. Meghamalai, Kazhugamalai, Kurangani Hills and Suruli and Kumbakkarai waterfalls are found on the Varusanadu and Andipatti Hills. Vaigai River and its tributaries originate in this region. Udigai Hills. It is major part lies in Tirunelveli district with its southern slope in the Kanyakumari district. So it is major part lies in the Tirunelveli district with southern slope in the Kanyakumari district. Udigai Hills is the major part lies in the Tirunelveli district and then southern slope in the Kanyakumari district. Udigai Hills are called with different names such as the Shiva Jyothi Parvat, Agastyar Hills and Southern Kailash. So there are the three names for them. Udigai Hills, that is Shiva Jyothi Parvat, Agastyar Hills and Southern Kailash. This area is known for its rich evergreen forest, waterfalls and ancient temples. Kalakkad Mundanthurai Tiger Reserve is located in this region. Now Mahendra Hills, Mahendra Giri Hills. Mahendra Giri Hills, it is a continuous range, is situated along the border of Kanyakumari and Tirunelveli district and is a part of the southern range of Western Ghats. Its average height is 1645 meters. So it is the Mahendra Giri Hills is the continuous range and situated in the border of Kanyakumari and Tirunelveli district and is a part of the southern range of Western Ghats. Average height is 1645 meters. Eastern Ghats. Next physiographic division is Eastern Ghats. It is a discontinuous and irregular one. It is dissected at many places by the rivers which drain into the Bay of Bengal. Its height ranges from 1100 to 1600 meters. Jawad Hills, Servarayan Hills, Kalrayan Hills, Kullimalai Hills and Pachamalai are the major hills in the Eastern Ghats of Tamil Nadu and are located in the northern districts of the state. Now we'll see about the Jawad Hills. It is an extension of the Eastern Ghats. Many peaks with the height of 1100 to 1150 meters are located on this range. Melpattu is the highest peak. So in the Jawad Hills, Melpattu is the highest peak. It is noted for its fruit bearing trees, medicinal herbs and sandalwoods. Due to illegal logging, sandalwood trees are disappeared now. Because of the illegal logging, illegal cutting trees, sandalwood trees or we couldn't see in the on the Jawad hills. Next, Kalvarayan hills. The name Kalvarayan comes from the word Karalar, the ancient name of the present tribes. So the tribe's name is called as Karalar. That on behalf of the Karalar tribes, the names comes for the Kalvarayan hills. It is another major range of hills in the eastern Ghats of Tamil Nadu. The height of this hill ranges from 600 to 1220 meters. Shervarayan hills. It is a mountain range located near the Salem city, with the height ranging from 1200 to 1620 meters. The name of the ranges comes from the local deity Shervarayan. So the name of the range comes from the local deity Shervarayan, the name of the female god Shervarayan. The highest peak in the southern part of eastern Ghat is located in this range. The peak is Solai Karadu and its height is 1620 meters. The highest peak in the eastern Ghat is Solai Karadu. Its height is 1620 meters. The hill station's Yerkad, which is known as poor man's Ooty. It is located on the Shervarayan hills. Shervarayan temples is the highest point, that is 1623 meters. Now Kolli hills. It is a small mountain range located in the Namakkal district. It covers an area of about 2800 square meter, 2800 square kilometer. It rises up to 1300 meters. Then several coffee plantations, fruits, flowers and silver oak estates are found in this region. Then Arpaleeswara temple, located on the Kolli hills. It is an important pilgrim center. Pachai Malai hills. It is the lowest hill range, spreads over the districts of Perambalur, Tiruchirappalli and Salem. In Tamil language, Pachai means green. The vegetation in this range is greener, so it is named as Pachai Malai. Jackfruit is the popular seasonal agriculture products of this hills. Pachai means greens, so vegetation in the range is greener, so it is called as Pachai Malai hills. Jackfruit is famous in the season. Plateaus. Plateaus of Tamil Nadu are located between the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats. It is roughly triangular in shape and covers an area of about 60,000 square kilometer. So plateaus between the Eastern Ghats and Western Ghats, we can see that is triangular shape and 60,000 square kilometer area of the plateaus. Baramahal Plateau, Coimbatore Plateau, Madurai Plateaus are the famous in the plateaus. Rivers like Bhavani, Noyal, Amaravati, which originate from the Western Ghats. Plains in Tamil Nadu may be divided into two, that is inland plains and coastal plains. Inland plains are drained by the rivers Palar, Ponnaiyar, Kaveri and Tamirabarani. Kaveri Plains is one of the most important fertile plains of the state. The plains of Kaveri is found in Salem, Erode, Karur, Trichy, Pudukottai, Tanjavur, Tiruvarur and Nagapattinam districts. So the Kaveri Plains you can see in the Salem, Erode, Karur, Tiruchirappalli, Pudukottai, Tanjavur, Tiruvarur and Nagapattinam districts. Now coastal plains. Coastal plains of Tamil Nadu are also called as Coromandel or Cholamandalam. That is land of Cholas. Cholamandalam, it means land of Cholas. So Cholamandalam plain, which extends from Chennai to Kanyakumari. It is formed by the rivers. Now the sand dunes formed along the coast of Ramanathapuram. The sand dunes, it means a heap of sand, that is called as sand dunes, heap of sand or sand dunes, formed along the coast of Ramanathapuram and Thoothukudi districts are called Terri. So where you can find out the Ramanathapuram and Thoothukudi district, the sand dunes you can see there, that is called as Terri, T-E-R-I, Terri. Terri, it means sand dunes, which you can find out in the or see in the place of Ramanathapuram and Thoothukudi. Coral rocks are found at the head of Gulf of Mannar in the east coastal plains. Coral rocks you can see in the Gulf of Mannar in the east coastal plains. Now beaches. The Coromandel coast along the Bay of Bengal consists of many beaches, like many beautiful and exotic, it means attracted beaches. Many beautiful and exotic, it means attractive beaches you can see in the Coromandel coast, that is the golden sands of Tamil Nadu beaches and scattered with the palm. So the golden sands of Tamil Nadu beaches are scattered with palm groves. So in the golden sands beach you can see the palm groves more. Then Marina, Iliad beach, Kovalam beach, Silver Sand beach are some of the famous beaches in Tamil Nadu.